I think I'd prefer it with other lighting, eh?
We'd have to get other lighting. Hey, everybody.
Because it's like coming back into my eyes here with the specs and skirts.
Yeah, but you wanted this whole stardom. You wanted to be in the spotlight. There's your spotlight. It's a ring light.
No, but it's hitting into my eye, making a migraine.
I can see the circles on your specs.
Yeah.
Like the circle is in this TV behind. Like over
welcome
there.
To Lallie's Life and Lallie's at Lallie's F1 Motorsports on TikTok.
Oh, calm down in your lane. How is that going to be the name? How did...
No, I'm just giving my social handles.
Oh, you're
giving
your social handles.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So on Instagram, I'm at Lallie's Life, Lallie's Life. And on TikTok, for my motorsport channel, I'm at Lallie's F1. Yeah.
Are you done?
Yeah.
Okay, before this whole thing was just completely taken over by Miss Ford over here, this is different than what you guys usually see. This is fancy. Look, we got leather couches. Her one reclines. She's all just kicking
yours
back.
Yours also reclines, Jason.
That's really how. Where's the button?
Feel on the side.
That's what she said. What's this here? What the? Oh my, this is fancy. Oh my God, I can just kick back over here. How did I never know this was here? I've been on this couch many times before. How did I not know this was the first night when you were on this couch?
You cannot say that. Cut that out.
Come, what am I missing here? What? Come.
Nothing. Let's go on.
No, it's too late now. You let the cat out the bag. The cat's running around the fucking house all wet. What's going on? I have to catch this pussy now. Anyway. Listen, we're talking a lot of shit here now. But, so the idea was, I had several podcasts a while ago. The thing is, though, okay, South Africans aren't really that into podcasts. They're just not.
No, a lot of people listen to it. A lot of people listen to overseas podcasts.
Yeah, yeah.
But they don't listen to South African podcasts.
Because we talk cuck, maybe we aren't interesting enough. But
there are some good ones.
There are a few.
The one that I'm on, the F1 one and Bet Central and Spotify.
That's nice though because it focuses on a specific subject, like the Formula One. But when you're just talking like random stuff, and the ones that I had before, I liked it because I like talking to people. So
can the camera see cola?
Guys, can you see the dog sitting right here?
She's just like...
Look here. That's here. That my hand is on her head. See? There she is. This is Cola. She's like completely... You can't even see her. She's completely ninja in this thing. It's crazy. You okay,
and she's just like...
Yeah, she's sitting there like a little princess. Like a little queen. So, my thing is, I just like talking to people. And I like talking to people...
Can't you bring my sunglasses?
Who know things... Your sunglasses?
This is so bright on my eyes.
Look, we're going to change this. We're just testing out now. All right? We're testing out the spot. Like, if we over here with, like, Lallie and a guest or myself and a guest talking about a couple of things. This is sort of the vibe, right? And we're just trying it out for size. We'll change a couple of things. The background music, like, you can see they've got the matador in the corner. Can you see the matador over there? That's, like, the thing that your granny used to have in the house. You know the matador?
I bought that from Spain, okay? So just slow your roll about the granny in the house.
Did you buy it for your granny?
No, I bought it for me as a thing to show that I was in Spain.
Well, my granny had both of those things now. So you know what she had about
that? Well, maybe granny went to Spain.
Granny had those three ducks. Are there three ducks flying into the distance? Or is it one duck flying into the distance or three separate ducks? She wants attention. They can't see what she's doing. They have no idea. And then a complete clash. Above that, you got Star Wars shit. You got Yoda in the back. You can't see Pikachu is right on top. You can't see Pikachu. And then this here is going to be a TV. So we're thinking about putting the camera a bit further back. And if we're talking about something in particular, we can put the whatever footage is on the TV. And I just think that'll be cool. And we're going to have our special guests every night. Charlie and Cola.
You can't see Charlie now. He's very busy.
He's very pissed off that Cola's on your lap. That's what his problem is. So, I've got a particular guest that I want to bring on again. His name is Brett van der Scaife. He's a psychologist talking about mental health and things. That was a very legal conversation the last time. You've also got something that you're interested in, somebody that you said you're going to do a podcast with, other than the F1 podcast.
Kissing me. So,
Oh, you love me better.
I've got two friends, actually.
Gosh, your mama.
First of all, one is not dating advice, but we're going to talk about boys, guys.
You're gonna trash men, basically.
No, we're going to be like, what is with guys? And, like, you know, where do they... Yeah, we want to... You see, men say we are the crazy ones, but...
Because you are, though.
But we listen to your stories and we listen to these things that hairdressers or wherever, beauty salons, having your nails done and you're talking or whatever. And you hear these stories and you're actually like, damn, that guy is whack. Like, you know? And so that is the one.
Listen, this one girl has her hair done and her nails done. My thing is, when women get together, women in a pack are dangerous. When women are in a pack and there's no men around,
it's guys not a pack, think, it's like two. It's if you're having pack. Your hair anything done, more it's than one you is and a, your hairdresser.
In women, it's a if more that's than two. One is a pack. No, it's about 10 because of your multiple personalities. How are you this morning? How are you this
my
afternoon?
Girl, do you want 100%. The line from this place? Do you want the line? Because I don't need to be here. You don't need to be here. You can go.
And okay, then what? Then you're gonna cry for me.
No, then we're going to slap this podcast off and I will make my own thing. Like a tally art on Firefly, Firebird, Netflix, whatever.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Anyway, then the other one is with another friend that I've sort of grown up with and we're still in contact. We're still best friends. And we were both in a relationship, well, our relationships in our lives or whatever. We were in a narcissistic relationship. So we want to talk about abuse, mental abuse, emotional abuse, trauma, and those kinds of things that women go through. And then they don't realize they're repeating patterns, and they don't also realize that that's toxic.
Yeah.
So, and look...
Who's that with?
With another friend of mine. So, and I'm not saying
it's... We're not naming names here.
No, so I'm not saying it's, it happens to women. Men experience the same thing, but obviously
that's why I'm here for the balance.
Obviously we are women, so we'll give it from our perspective.
And I'm the guy, so I'll give it from our perspective.
Who said I'm going to have you on my show?
Who said I'm going to have you on my show?
I never said I want to be on your show.
I never said I want to be on your show either.
Whatever.
Are you done talking trash?
See there. See how she looks at her mom.
She's looking at you saying, shut the fuck up, bro. I'm comfortable. What are you doing?
She will.
Look, it's going to be lighthearted. We're not trying to make this serious. Action. There's going to be obviously serious topics, but we don't want it to be that kind of thing, man. It's just going to be us talking. We do a lot of this on TikTok, and it's liquor because we get interaction with people as we're talking. So that's nice.
We do it on his channel on TikTok, and people like to comment, and we speak about a lot of stuff that people don't like to comment, speak about in general. Like last night we were talking about death, and for example...
Yeah, that sounds like a downer.
Anyway, the person dies, and you've told your partner or your boyfriend or your girlfriend, I want to be buried like this. Now, we were speaking and saying, but you need to tell that person. So say, for example, Jason doesn't want to be buried traditionally or cremated. He wants to be left in the bush, like in a jungle vibe.
Yeah, but not cuck bush. Don't throw me there, but delve somewhere.
But the thing is, he can't tell me that. He can tell me that. It's fine. But he needs to tell his family because I'm his friend. So once he passes away and like I let his family know, whatever, and we discuss things, who am I to tell them how to bury their loved one? So that's what we were speaking about last night. Mm-hmm. And people were like, this is a good topic because people need to know these things.
And you know what else we were talking? So in those conversations on TikTok, we talk about a lot of that thing. A lot of it comes down to adult conversation. We talk about sex. We talk about the relationships like you were saying earlier on. So that is sort of the kind of conversations that we want to have. She's obviously got her perspective. We bump heads on a lot of fucking things. But I think the nice thing is at the age that we're at, we can disagree. And if we were 22, 24, 25 years old and we had these kinds of disagreements, we'd be tearing each other's eyes out. But because we've grown, you get some fucking life experience, you learn that not everything is an attack. We are allowed to have different opinions. We are allowed to not agree with certain things because we are completely different people. But doesn't mean we're going to hate each other. So that's kind of what this is sort of about. Different guests, us chatting about things every now and again. What do you think about the setup as it is here, though?
So we have to move the printer, obviously. That thing don't even work anymore.
We can't even see it. So, yeah, the printer. We don't see... We're trying to look at the framing of this whole thing. If we move the camera back a bit, you'd see more of what's on top here.
Oh, you know what? I think it's cool. You can make that your side. Like, so, like, stuff with your...
axes and swords and skulls
and... No, please. And then...
Why are we comparing?
Whatever. Yeah, we just have to put something in there that looks a bit better, and then on top, and the screen is a bit, yeah, but the thing is we can plug in my MacBook, and then if we want to show something, we can be like, oh.
Yeah, that's sort of the idea with this over here. So if we...
I just had an example.
Example me?
Like, what if we had TikTok on the MacBook open, and then the comments are going there, and we're reading it here.
Is this a...
Can you HDMI, yeah.
Can you screencast this thing?
Yeah.
It's possible we could do... So the possibilities are endless. That's a cool idea. So the idea was first, apparently, these two chairs that we're sitting in come apart from this middle vibe here.
But he couldn't figure it out.
Well, you didn't do it when you came in here. You just hit it on clips. And it's still together. I will break this thing with
Must I do it now?
Do it. No, man, I'm joking. Don't do it. So the idea is to move this thing...
Yeah, because you don't
look for sun. No, it's your stuff. You should know how to work it. So we move this thing out the way, right? Then you can see more of that TV. We're going to sort of angle these chairs a little bit more like this. Right? That's sort of what I'm thinking. And then, yeah, these are the special guests and the superstars. Like... They can't be here all the time. But if they're not here, they will bark. Yes, okay, mama. Okay. They will bark whole night. So that's the idea. Adult conversation, we must still figure out a name. And, because there's going to be...
Lallie! Jason's podcast.
Whose idea was this? Jason and Lallie's podcast.
The female always comes before the man.
Yeah, we don't need to get into that right now.
But, okay, if you want to be alphabetical, then it's J before L.
And it's both Williams, technically.
The Williams podcast.
Holy shit.
It's not my government name now, though.
It's not your government. It's your original name. We'll figure it out. We must need to figure out the name for this thing. This was just literally about to see, can this work? And where were we going to put it? YouTube and then clips to TikTok? What did we do? The normal way to do it would be YouTube, rip the audio for Spotify, Google Podcasts, and whatever. If we want to go there, dude. Or we just move the whole fucking thing on YouTube and people can listen or watch it from there. And see where it goes from that. So yeah, that's all the behind the scenes stuff, but that's kind of the idea. What?
She's not growling for him.
She's growling for him, yeah.
Yeah.
You said, come up here, come, Charlie, come, up. Come up here. Let him see Charlie, man. Can I see him? No, he's hiding. You guys can't see. Oh, there's Charlie. Say hi. Easy. And Ringo's the best boy. Ringo's the other pooch. He's laying there on the couch. He was there by the fire last night.
I just got this song in my head, man.
Which song?
Habibi, Lamborghini.
This antenna made a reel tonight. That was fire. The track behind it was good.
Even he said it was quiet.
Well, it was quiet. But then she get mad at me. Wait, how does explain this cut to me, right? I'm like, oh my goodness, this is... And legitimately, the best reel she's ever made. I like, this is a very, very good reel. The best you've ever made. And what about all the others? I'm like, well, can't it be a best one? Can't it be a best out of all of them? No, now I'm the bad guy.
But out of my 390,000 reels, it's like, this one is the best.
Yeah, it is the best one. It's timed with the music nicely. The music suits the video nicely. It is the best one. If I had to choose one and somebody said, gun to your head, what's Lallie's best reel? I'm going to go the Lambo with her baby song. Why is that a bad thing? I'm not saying the others are cut.
What is the make of the Lambo?
It's a Lamborghini Huracan. Why?
I just want to know.
Are you trying to get me stuck?
Super Trofeo.
Yes.
Just go Google it. You'll see my real come up.
Okay, now we're just babbling. We can talk for hours. We're going to
look at this child. He looks like he's depressed.
He is depressed. Well, he's not paying attention to him.
What's wrong, my boy? What's wrong?
All right, so we're going to figure this out. We don't know how it's going to go. We don't know where it's going to go. I'm super excited to have guests because although we can get a good conversation going and whatever, I want to chat to people like we did before. People that are in a different industry to mine, people that are professionals in what they do, people that are funny, people that are intelligent, people that are crazy. Just chat to new people, man. So.
But how do you know people are crazy? Maybe you're the crazy one and they're normal.
So I want to chat to more people like her because she's fucking crazy. You know what happened this evening? Let me just tell you what happened this evening quickly since we're on the subject, right? We went to go get currywurst because of a craving. Then...
What is even currywurst? Do the people know?
It's a wurst with curry. So, she went to... Last night, she's complaining to me about how they went into Woolies. Woolies, she couldn't get a particular ice cream from Woolies, so she got one. She got a vanilla ice cream. So, she got a tub of vanilla ice cream in the freezer. She's also got a tub of Tin Roof ice cream in the freezer.
I don't eat much ice cream, people.
But the point to my story, we're driving past the Woolies, and I'm saying, I smoked a sticky cake. Nothing crazy. I wanted like a Copenhagen or a Cinnabon or something. I just smoked for a piece of cake. She's coming going to Woolies. But not so much for my cake. She wants to go into Woolies to buy the ice cream that she never got yesterday. And I'm like, wait, hold on. You've already got two tubs of ice cream in your freezer. Now you still want to go get the peppermint one as
not
well.
Not peppermint, the fantastical one.
The fantastic whatever it is. So you want 6 liters of ice cream in your freezer that you never eat. But then she's my duck back for me.
Because I thought you could
share 2 liter ice cream.
No, like, I want you to taste it. It's a new ice cream.
You'd have one spoon and it's going to lum in the freezer and I'll finish it. Tell me I'm lying. Tell me. But then she's...
But it looks so little.
Then she's bolavanga for me. I'm the bad guy for talking fucking sense.
Bolavanga.
Then, hold on. Then, we drive around the corner from the house, right? I'm going to jump into the Checkers because I'm going to go get me a fucking jam donut or something. I just wanted a small piece of cake. Nothing much. She said to me, why are you coming to this Checkers is common?
She's like, I did not say that.
Checkers is common.
I did not.
So where the fuck do you want to go? No, she want to go to the Checkers in Constantia.
Your master.
She want to go to the Checkers in Constantia. We drive all the way back to where we just came from to Checkers in Constantia.
Jason, you could have gone to 3 Arts Woolies. I didn't have to go there to Checkers.
You wanted to go. I said, I didn't have to go to any particular place.
My friend said that's such a nice
After
Checkers,
you brought it
I
up.
I want to go there. So I
never said I want to go
you
there.
You said you want
to. I just said oh, everyone. You said. You said it was nice. I'm like, I've heard that before. I've never been. I've heard everybody talk about this place.
Oh my fuck.
Then you were like, oh, now can we go? I'm like, we literally just came. We almost drove past the place.
No. Also. It doesn't take the wrong turn again.
What are you talking? I didn't take the wrong turn.
Yes, you turned that way instead of that way. Yo, my head feels like it's exploding.
Oh, God.
Because it took a club cack.
I spoke 100% truth now.
Look, my boy, man.
100% truth. You want to twist the story? They'll be just be comfortable like this all the time.
So, number one, we get to the Checkers. Number two, he says, Sassy. Oh, you know the Checkers by Constantia Port. I don't actually go there, by the way, people.
On the way in the car, she's putting lip gloss on. She's fucking spraying. I'm like, where the fuck are we going? How quiet is this place?
Don't lie. And so
fuck. Because she's laughing. Because she's laughing. Now I must be the one to look like I'm psycho.
So, I said to him, so he says, yeah, you know, my friends say that's the only one they go to now. Da, 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 da,
yeah, da. That's what I heard.
So I was like, okay, now you want to go see it? He's like, yeah, let's go.
He never once said, no,
I don't want to go. You did not say, no, I don't want
to
go.
Because you never made it as if it was a suggestion to me. You never suggested it. You're like, oh, do you want to go? In women speak, that's like, come we go.
No.
In women speak, that's come we go.
No, you drug me up really when you want the ice cream. That was like 20 minutes before that. So I was like, yeah, whatever. I will go home now. So now you said you want to go there. So I said, okay, I'll go there. I mean, I could have come
I never
home.
Said I want to go there. I wanted to go to the one we were at. We were outside the Checkers. I was by the parking. No, I was parked. The car was parked. I'm ready to jump out and go in. No, common Checkers. I don't want to go in.
You're lying.
I want to go into the Constantia Checkers.
You're lying.
They were the outdoor numbers. Then we're shopping. Now we're by the outdoor places. She's looking at
things. Jason.
She's looking at hooters there. The dark voices is coming through the fucking speakers. It's Malachi there. It's looking at the 32,000 Rand Weber. How's a Weber 32,000 Rand? For a fucking Weber, man. For a Weber.
Yo, if you're going to talk cuck like this in the podcast, we are not going to do podcasts.
What do you think this is?
We are not going to do podcasts.
The way she's laughing, it's giving guilt vibes to me.
No, Jason.
Because you know what it is.
Jason.
That's what happened.
You said, I said, oh yeah, the outdoor house, outdoor section is here.
Yes.
And you were like, oh, so I was like, oh yeah, so we can go check it out. So you're like, should we go first or should we go there?
Yeah.
Now you're acting like this whole thing was my idea.
I never said that one time. What you said is 100% right. I'm not disputing that at all. But that is what happened. We went to the outdoor warehouse first. We're going to fucking Checkers. Hold the fuck on. Hold this phone. We're going to Checkers, right? I'm like, oh, see, it is fancy. It's
you know,
nice.
I can't see the camera, eh?
It'll be there, don't worry.
Because my specs are off.
We're both there. We go into this Checkers. She pull out the trolley. I'm like, where the fuck are you going with the trolley? I'm coming to buy a cake. I want to buy a cake. She pull out the trolley. Then she get, she's going crazy because...
I thought
because
I was going to see Indomie noodles. The,
and you're going to put the trolley full.
Jace, so first of all, number one, I just wanted a trolley. Like, no, it's like a security blanket, whatever. It's like to push around. In a shop, if you don't have a trolley, it feels boring.
Okay. In the trolley, they've got the day's latest special. She says, oh, look how awesome this is. And it's quite an idea. They've got a small little thing there where they roll up the, like the
in
newspaper
the cup,
thing.
In the cup holder.
The cup holder, the newspaper thing is there.
They put the newspaper thing in. This is like so cool. That's very ingenious.
I took that piece of paper.
Why do you want to take it away? I don't buy my chickens anyway, so what the jazz?
What do you mean, what the jazz? I'm just taking...
I just wanted to look at the
any
prices.
Any temptation. Just taking any temptation.
Oh, man. Anyway, we didn't get through the shop very far because his leg was sore and he said we have to leave. So we left.
I never said that.
Yes, you said how long, how far. Because you know the rest of the shop I wanted to see still. They got liquor stuff in that shop.
But you didn't say nothing.
Because I saw your leg was sore. You were hobbling.
But now I'm the bad guy. You're making it sound like I'm the
bad
guy.
No, you're not the bad person. But I'm just saying, don't go so on about me and acting like I went to shop the whole shop because we left after the fourth aisle. Okay, we didn't even get to the aisles. So please.
I never said nothing at all.
You are hollering there by the cakes.
I wanted to see the cakes.
Should I get this cake? Oh,
yeah,
should I get that cake?
Yeah, because that's why I was there for the cake. I went for the cake.
You took forever by the cake. If you see a nice cake, you're going to take the cake. Now you sit there the whole time. You know, it's like almost like we were reading ingredients.
Why can't I just decide what cake I want?
And eventually he said, I don't like anything. After 20 minutes.
It wasn't 20 minutes. Anyway, we go to Woolies. But now she's for air with me. I can tell. Now she's for air with me. First of all, Woolies got fuck all. Woolies got nothing. It's the end of the day.
Yo, that was there, but Checkers Emporium is cuck.
There was nothing
the
there.
The one I got to Belvedere is half the size of Checkers Emporium, and they had more variety in there.
So there are a couple
and
of
apple danishes
chocolate croissants there. They had a few, one or two jam donuts, and then the...
Even the one at 3 hours is better.
But then they had the pre-packed one, like the stuff is packed on the shelves.
Mm.
Right? And at the end of it, she was like, so hot.
But
like,
no, you know
take this carrot cake. Take a carrot cake in line. Just go.
No, but I like the carrot cake.
You didn't even have... I had it just now.
As I didn't feel like when I came home.
Who else eats carrot cake and warms it up first?
Nobody fucking does it.
A lot of people do that.
No,
I warmed it up a bit here and
no,
put some ice cream
did,
on it.
You did. You for sin.
Just because that's the way I like it, don't make me for sin. Where's the bowl of olives that you ate now? Where's the bowl of olives when I come call me for sin?
I'm eating bowl of olives every night now.
This one is olive starty. Anyway, that... I couldn't have summed up what this podcast is going to be about more than what just happened now. This fucking madness.
Well, this is happens. This is what happens on TikTok, and everybody absolutely loves it. And like we literally.
Then she goes British for no reason. for no reason.
Guys, what do people call me? What have they called me before?
What do they call you? I don't know.
Like when I can speak all this funny stuff and I say like, yeah, she's on tonight. Whatever. Guys, the TikTok lives, sometimes we're on there for like 3-4 hours because we're only limiting it now because of load shedding. But the people love us being on there and love us being like ridiculous, but also speaking about a whole lot of like life things.
This is real life shit. This is what you saw now. It's daily. This is the...
Yeah, like he made my boss fight him now. Because he's
dirty, man. For fuck's sake. So, and here's the thing, right? This is just everybody experiences. Ooh. Am I boring you? Am I boring you?
It's been normal.
Your old age, I'm not a kaki. So,
you're older than me, bro.
Isn't this, yeah, bro, whoops.
You want to nap some chickens?
How are you going to use my disability against me? Yeah. Listen, what we're getting at is this is real people stuff. This is how friends interact. This is how spouses interact. This is how people and workplaces interact. This is just normal. And that's what this is. So if you're not down with normal and real life shit, then this is not going to be for you. You know, we're just being really honest about it.
Yeah, and I'm not going to sit here with your what's up makeup on and whatever. I'm going to be here plain Jane in front of you.
In a Rocking the Daisies hoodie.
Yeah.
Hair up in a bola.
Yeah.
No specs on, can't see fuck all what's going on there.
No.
And I'm going to be in my Thor and Bradley fucking lumberjack outfit.
You know, the whole day today, I couldn't get this bola right. I think it's my hair's too clean or something.
You see how she's starting to flex now? Did you check that subtle flex?
That's not flex.
That's a clean, still hair in my hair, straight. It just fall out all the time. She's got genuine hair, man. She got genuine hair, and she let you know about it.
Glad
she
will
let you know. What's happening, Cola?
Look, he's very disturbed by her, no?
I don't know why. He's comfortable on that side. I don't know. What's the issue?
If this dog must take a cuck here now, yo, I will get dust for this dog.
I'm sweet there now because this couch that we're sitting on was actually meant to be on the other side of the camera. I've got to move all this cuck back now. So
but
every time we do a podcast...
But it shows me, though, that she's not cleaning here.
Yo, also the couch is poos heavy.
No, it's heavy. Not. And Gladys, her mother used to clean here nicely. And Cynthia. I'm a very wise person. I'm very wise and
you want some knitting needles.
Experience.
In what?
In life.
Mm-hmm.
But I've got a lot of advice to give to people. And I'm at that age now, you know.
I've got no advice whatsoever. The only advice I've got is bad advice because I'm not about to give advice on my fuck up of a life. My life has not gone smoothly. My life is a fucking roller coaster. I've made mistakes, but you know what? I've realized we've all made fucking mistakes. We are all human.
No, so for
and we
example,
can learn from each other's mistakes, maybe. So I'll just say, guys, I fucked up with this. It's not advice, but don't do that. I can tell you what not to do. I can't tell you what to do.
So, for example, I was speaking to my mother about somebody I know. Maybe around my age or so. I don't know how old this person is. So my mother says, you know, it sounds like this person doesn't have an elder in their family to speak to them. And she says she doesn't have somebody to talkie-talkie to them. Now, when she says to me, I talkie-talkie to you, that means it's like a little bit of a serious talk. But it's true. Sometimes you can see people don't have the wisdom of the elders speaking to them. And this is what I'm here for.
Just the way you're laughing right now, after you realize the cuck that came out of your mouth. All right, I don't even know how long is this going on now. Yeah, it's like half an hour. That's actually not a bad. If this was a full podcast, that would be the end of it. We would just talk more things. But I think that idea that you had is not bad, where we do like a TikTok live. People are somewhere, have the camera over there and asking questions, and we somehow touch on those. We can figure it out. But for the most part, this is what it's going to be. And I hope you guys
will
watch it.
Yeah, but with the TikTok, we have to have the thing like that, unless I have my TikTok going, where the camera is like that for them, because if it's like this, people don't want to move their phone like this.
Yeah, but look, if it does, look, TikTok is just going to be for clips. We can't load a whole podcast up there. It'll just be clips of.
Yeah, I know, but I'm saying I could maybe go live on my phone.
Oh yeah,
and have that or have it plugged into the computer somewhere like we worked out.
We'll figure it out.
Yeah, but I mean, why must you make things so complicated?
Are you making complicated? I just wanted to do this. I want to do this. I'm done. This. I would do this.
Colin's like, what?
All right. Half an hour's gone. You guys have...
Yeah, I got very dry, bad dry eye today. My eyes are so mean.
I told you put Q20. You don't want to listen. Doesn't make sense. 20/20 vision. Q20. Talk about wisdom. What's happening, Baba?
She's trying to tell you to stop talking crap to her mommy.
That's why she's sitting here by me, giving you loves.
God, in an hour and a half's time, and it's bloody load shedding for 4 hours.
4 fucking hours.
You know we've had load shedding for 16 years now.
No way.
Yep.
Has it been that long?
Yeah.
I've not even realized it. It's only now that it's getting like really cuck. Because at the beginning it was like an hour here, an hour there. Something like small little bits. But now it's fucked.
And yesterday, you know what?
The day before it was like 11 and a half hours for the day.
And you know what the funny thing is this is how it happens. We've allowed it. We as consumers and citizens have allowed it.
Yeah, but what could we have done, to be honest, other than deny it?
A friend of mine is a journalist, and he always says he wishes South Africans become more like the French people when there's things to protest against. So, and I said to him, I fully agree. Like when I was overseas before, and it was happening, I happened to go to France, but I was in London at that time, and then I had to take a plane over. And here you see French fuel strike.
Mm.
The truckers.
Oh yeah.
They literally pack all the highways. You cannot get into to Paris. They block everything off until the government said no fuel hike.
Mm.
They stopped it. Now we. Oh, we're not gutsy enough to do that.
Yeah.
You know, when we get those days of no car to work day or ride your bicycle or jam the highways, we don't. We don't do it.
You know what I think
we do it for about 10 minutes till the cops come and then we're done because we're scared.
You know what? We are scared though because, look, I don't know what it's like in France. I've not been. I don't know what the quality of life is over there. But if you look at it locally, I can't say like, I'm not going to go to work today because this, like, I need to get paid because there's bills to pay.
No, I understand that, but so do they. So do they. I mean, so do truckers. I mean, truckers are...
True.
You know, this is their bread and butter.
There you go.
And the thing is, if you're going to increase the fuel, you're going to cut into their bread and butter. But this is when all of them stand together and are like, hell no. And then, of course, it also is an advantage for everybody else in the country.
Mm.
But that is our thing. We have violent protests.
Yeah.
In London, every other day, somebody's protesting, somebody's laying on a street, and there's like literally cops around the person, and they can't move them.
You know what the protests are locally? As far as I'm concerned, the mass protests that we have locally is more opportunists jumping on board thinking, okay, there's going to be a bit of chaos over there. We're going to go through, and a lot of it's orchestrated. We're going to smash windows. We're going to steal shit. It's a lot of people that are just opportunistic to go and cause shit so they can steal some stuff. It's very few of the people that protest locally that are actually protesting for a particular cause. And that's what's kind
of
cuck.
The thing is, like, imagine all of us had to become gutsy and brazen and decide not to pay PAYE tax over.
They would forget fuck.
Imagine all the employees in the whole country, all the businesses, we do not pay SARS for 1 month.
They will fucking die.
Will they all of a sudden start working then?
Mm-hmm.
It's like, we need to step up and do something, or we're just going to sit in the dark like Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe is almost 18 hours, sometimes 24 hours a day.
That shit is
and crazy. This is life. This is what life is going to be. So, you know? So either we just shut the F up and we just carry on with gas and inverters and whatever, or us as a country maybe try to do something.
Give us your suggestions below. If you've gotten this long in this...
I mean, look what we're sitting here. Of a podcast. There's two power banks down there. One charging my phone, one for this light. Then, if we do this podcast with no electricity next time, so that light won't be on, then we'll have the other rechargeable lights here. And I have the Wi-Fi on UPS.
Yep, this is what life
is. This is all charged. So, the mics are all charged.
So it just shows, like, I don't want to say the resilience, but I mean,
No.
We've become resilient. We're getting around the problem. We should have to get around it, but we are.
You know, I was looking at that when we went camping. I was looking at that at the camping store, and I was looking at the camping, and I used to go camping, and I enjoyed camping, but now I'm like, why must I go camping when I'm already camping in my house? Like, what's the point?
I want to go camping. I want to go fishing.
What is the point of, and actually, are people still camping as much as they used to? Like, because now I must pack the car with the tent, pack in all the rechargeables anyway.
Pretty much what you did it's the past weekend what for Neisner.
It's basically what we're doing, like taking stuff away. All I need now is the tent and the ice, the cooler boxes.
It's the stuff we normally live with. It's just going to, we're going to go do it outside now.
Yeah. It's like, I was like, actually, you know what? Just keep the doors of the house open and we can camp.
Yeah. I was saying, I'm not going to put it this, a friend of mine, her son went glamping, right? So, AfriCamps. So this is not glamping, right? You've got hot water, you've got a heater inside your tent. It's a tent, ultimately, but all the modern conveniences are inside that tent.
Really nice.
Right? But they went, ultimately, it's still a tent. There's still holes in the side, there's still holes at the bottom.
That is AfriCamps.
They went for about 2 days. On the third day in the evening, wherever this was, it's been cold past week.
Yeah.
They were freezing. It was a family, husband, wife, kids. The last night, they all slept. They huddled together in one bed with every single piece of clothing they had, all the blankets on them, trying to get body heat. They left. I think they had a week holiday. They left 2 days into it. They're like, fuck that. It's just too cold. It is too cold.
Can you guys imagine now in winter when we used to people are used to the electric blankets and heaters? We're going to go back to the hot water bodies.
Yeah.
The fireplace or even, I remember, this one lady used to work for us. And she always used to take my mother's vodka bottles with a square bottle.
Your mom's had vodka bottles. Let's go.
And I'm like, why does she have? She always, at night, and she says night or whatever, she used to be a living lady. She don't wonder what happened to her. Anyway, and she'd say night now, and she'd take this bottle wrapped in newspaper. And I'm like, what is she doing?
Old school.
So the one night I said to my mommy, I'm going to go sleep by her, because I used to have like sleepovers by her. Uh-huh. So now I'm laying on the bed, and I'm like, what the hell is so hot? And so she shows me, that's a hot water bottle. Yeah. And it's actually warmer than the rubber.
The rubber hot water bottle.
But the thing is, obviously, it's safer to have rubber. I mean, yeah, you don't want to kick the blanket open and there goes the bottle.
Wake up in the middle of the night, fucking blood everywhere. Looks like a murder scene. Like, what the fuck is going on?
But if you think about it now, like, those people experience how cold it was. Mm. And we're going into winter where we use more electricity.
Yeah. Just going to be fucked up. Listen, my cure for, you want to be warm in your sleep? One glass of Old Brown Sherry, you will sleep right through the night.
You just need three dogs. I sleep with three dogs. Something went, you know. There was a green something in a wood.
Maybe it's a spook. Like last night on the TikTok, somebody was saying, who's there behind you? Maybe you got a spook in your house that we aren't seeing. Only shows up on the camera. Okay, it was a long fucking conversation. If you guys are here till the end, we ended this podcast 15 times a day. We're going to end it for reals now. Let's see where this goes. Hope you guys come along for the ride. Cheers.
You have to press stop.
Give me a fist bump. You're just gonna be hanging here. Uh-huh. Yes, sis. Okay, Carla, I need to put the thing off. Baba, go put off there. Then you must move. Come.
Sure, this light is terrible on my eyes, eh?
Yeah, we must.
I think the lighting that we normally use, we can hang here because...